Hello everyone. So in the last lecture, we have discussed about certain methods in which we can write the equation of lines, okay? Equation of line in 3D geometry. So in this lecture, we are going to discuss the planes and various methods in which we can write the equation of plane. What are the different forms of equation of plane? And then finally, we will solve some questions regarding writing about the equation of certain planes. ओके सो चलिए स्टार्ट करते हैं. अभी मान लीजिए आपको ऐसा कुछ बोला जाए कि एक कोई पॉइंट है किसी पी पर्टिकुलर पी पॉइंट से एक प्लेन पास हो रहा है. ओके सो उस प्लेन का इक्वेशन लिखी है ना. सो देयर विल बी इन्फिनाइटली मैनी प्लेन्स पासिंग थ्रू अ पॉइंट. ओके इसको आप ऐसे समझ सकते हो, कंसिडर दिस बुक है ना. सबके पास एक बुक होगी तो वो आप देख सकते हो. दिस मेनी पेजेज ऑफ द बुक्स आर डिफरेंट प्लेन्स एंड दिस बाइंडिंग लाइन इज कॉमन इन ऑल दिस प्लेन्स. सो इफ आई टेक एनी पॉइंट ऑन दिस बाइंडिंग लाइन, ओके सो दिस पी पॉइंट इज इन प्लेन पी वन पी टू पी थ्री. आई कैन से दिस पी पॉइंट इज लाइंग ऑन एवरी पेज दैट इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग डिफरेंट डिफरेंट प्लेन्स. ओके सो दिस इंफॉर्मेशन दैट plane passing through a point is not a sufficient information for us to write the unique equation of that plane. Okay, so it means there must be another information, and that information is called the direction. Okay, so in the last lecture we have discussed that the direction of a straight line is given by a parallel vector. Okay, but in case of plane, if I say that say this vector suppose b vector is parallel to this plane say p1, okay so you can clearly see that this vector b, I have put this vector b in line with the binding line. Okay so very clearly we can see that this b vector is parallel to plane p1, it is also parallel to plane p2, in fact it is parallel to all these pages. Okay so it means this parallel vector is not going to give us the direction of a plane. So what will be that vector which gives us the direction of the plane? That is a perpendicular vector, okay, which we call as normal vector. So if say this is our plane p1, this plane is p1, okay so this normal vector is giving us the direction of this plane. Okay if I slightly rotate this plane p1, this normal vector is will not be same, it will also be rotated. Okay so I can say this, let us consider this plane to be p2 plane. Okay so the direction of this plane will be a normal vector which is again perpendicular to this plane p2. Let's say this is the normal vector. Okay so direction of any plane is given by its normal vector. So far we have discussed that the direction of a plane is determined by its normal vector. Okay so let us consider that this is a plane and its normal vector is given by this n vector. Okay so in order to write the equation of this plane, we are required to write an equation that will be satisfied by all the points on the plane, and that equation must not satisfy for any point which is not in the plane. Okay let's see, this A point is lying in the plane. Okay so we are going to write the equation of a plane passing through point A, which position vector is A vector, and is normal, this plane is normal to vector n. okay so we are required to find a certain relation or equation which must satisfied by all the points in the plane, and it must not satisfy any point which is not in the plane. Okay, so in order to write the equation, let me consider a general point r whose position vector is, let's say, r vector. Okay, so if I join this vector, let me say a r vector. Okay, so this a r vector is formed by joining two points which points are lying in the plane itself. Okay, so this a r vector is completely inside the plane. Okay, I can say completely on the plane would be a better sentence. Okay, completely on the plane. Okay, so if a r vector is on the plane and this normal vector n is perpendicular to the plane, it means a r vector is also perpendicular to our normal vector. And if two vectors are perpendicular, it means their dot product must be zero. So a r vector is what? It's nothing but r minus a vector dot n vector is equal to zero. So this relation will be satisfied by each and every point, because we have considered this point to be any general point on the plane. Okay, so this r vector is any general point on the plane. So this relation is basically our equation of plane, which will be satisfied by each and every point which is lying inside the plane. And this relation will not be satisfied by any other point which is not on the plane. Let me say this is a point, let's say B, okay, having position vector B. So if I join this B to A to get this AB vector, okay, so you can clearly visualize here this AB vector is not perpendicular to our, because AB vector is not inside the plane. Okay, AB vector is not lying on the plane, so we can assume that AB vector is not perpendicular to our normal vector n vector. Okay, so it means that B minus A dot n vector is not going to be zero. Okay, so this is our equation of plane, and that equation of plane is written in vector form. Okay, we can easily convert this vector form into our 3D form or Cartesian coordinate form. Our r vector is always, this is a general point x, y, z. So in vector we can write it as x I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap. A vector, A is the point which is given to us, A, because the plane was passing through A. So it is given to us that, let's say, x1, A point to be x1, y1, z1. Okay, this is a given point. So in vector I will write this position vector of A as x1 I plus y1 j plus z1 k cap. And this normal vector is also given to us. Let us say this is a I plus b j plus c k cap. Okay, so we can put all these vectors in the above equation to get x minus x1 I cap plus y minus y1 j cap plus z minus z1 k cap. This is our r minus a vector dot a I plus b j plus c k cap is equal to zero. Okay, so we will get x minus x1 into a plus y minus y1 into b plus z minus z1 into c is equal to what? Zero. So we will write this as ax plus by plus cz is equal to ax1 plus by1 plus cz1. This is a constant number for us, okay, because x1, y1, z1 is given to us, a, b, c is also given to us. So this will be any constant. I can represent it as d. So our final equation will be ax plus by plus cz is equals to d. Okay, so in Cartesian form I can write the equation of plane as ax plus by plus cz is equals to d. Okay, so this is a linear equation in three variable. Any linear equation in three variable represents a plane in 3D. Okay, more observation we can observe that this coefficient of x, y, and z are a, b, and c. What was a, b, and c? A, b, and c are the components of normal vector. Okay, so it means, for example, if I am given this plane, let's say x plus 2y plus 3z is equal to 4. So our normal vector for this plane would be I cap plus 2j cap plus 3k cap. Okay, so whatever the coefficients of this x, y, and z in the Cartesian form of plane are basically the components of normal vector. Okay, so this was the equation of any plane which is passing through the point A and is normal to the vector n vector. Okay, so this thing only you can remember. So let me write some important point here. In order to find the equation of plane, always look for only two things. Okay, what are these two things? The first one is at least one point on the plane. Okay, what is second is a normal vector or perpendicular vector to the plane. Okay, if these two things are given to us, one point and a normal vector, then we can write the equation of any plane. Okay, good. So this was the very basic form of plane. Let us write the equation of plane in some other forms. Okay, when some other informations will be given to us. The first one is plane containing two lines. Okay, अभी एक प्लेन में अपने को कोई भी दो लाइन दे दिया ना, मान लेते ये लाइन है, दिस लाइन इज से आर इक्वल टू ए प्लस लेमडा टाइम्स बी वन. ओके, एंड द अदर लाइन इज से आर इक्वल टू ए टू प्लस म्यू टाइम्स बी टू. ओके, इफ बी वन एंड बी टू आर नॉट पैरेलल or not collinear, then the line will be intersecting because the line arcs in a plane. Okay, so let us consider that this is the second line. Okay, this is the second line, first line, second. These lines may be parallel, it may not be parallel. Okay, so how can we write the equation of the plane? We are looking for a point which is lying in the plane. If this line is completely inside the plane, then this point A1 is also in the plane. Okay, also we can say that the line 2, that is the second line, is also completely inside the plane. It means that this point A2 will also be in the plane itself. Okay, so we are looking for only one point, but we are given two points, so no problem for us. Let us say this is the first point A1, this is second point A2 on the second line. Okay, now we are interested in finding a normal direction for the plane. Okay, first line is parallel to a vector, that is B1. Second line is parallel to a vector, that is B2. Okay, it means lines are completely lying in the plane itself. Okay, it means these vectors B1 and B2 are parallel to the plane itself. If B1 and B2 are parallel to the planes, let me write, if lines are in the plane, then B1 and B2 are parallel to the plane. you can visualize. So B1 cross B2 will be perpendicular to the plane. We are interested in finding a perpendicular direction. Okay, so that perpendicular direction is B1 cross B2 in this case. Okay, so we required only two things. One is point, another is normal vector. Okay, so now we can write the equation of plane. Equation of plane is R minus any one point. You can use A1, you can also use A2, because A1, A2, both points are on the plane itself. Okay, so I have written A1, you can also write A2 in the place of A1 dot what, any parallel, sorry, perpendicular vector. In this case, this perpendicular vector is nothing but B1 cross B2. Okay, so R minus A1 vector dot B1 cross B2, because what we have discussed previously, R minus A, this equation of plane passing through A, normal to N vector is given by R minus A dot N vector is equal to 0. In this case, R minus A1 dot B1 minus B2 is equal to 0. Okay, you can also, if you also want to write this thing to be in another form, you can clearly see that this is a vector, this is a second vector, this is a third vector. So this is basically the scalar triple product of three vectors. So I can also write this equation in this form, R minus A, B1 and B2, scalar triple product of these three vectors is equal to 0. Okay, and no need to memorize all these cases. Okay, the only thing you must remember, that always look for a point and always look for a normal vector. Okay, fine. Let us consider the other case, that is equation of plane passing through three non-collinear points. Okay, why I have written this term non-collinear? Because if the points are, because if the points are collinear, it means they are on the same line. So there may be different planes passing through all these points. Okay, so there will not be a unique plane passing through these three collinear points. Okay, so for the plane to be unique, the points must be what? Must be non-collinear. So let me consider this point to be some A point. Here is some B point having position vector B. Here is some point C having position vector C. Okay, so there will be only one such plane which will be passing through these three non-collinear points. Okay, so how do we write the equation of these planes? So we'll try to look for two things. One is any point. So in this case, we are given three points, more than enough. Okay, other thing is we want to look for a normal vector. Okay, any normal vector to the plane, any normal vector to the plane. So if I join these points A and B, I'll get this AB vector, and if I join this A point to C, I'll get this AC vector. This AB and AC vector are in the plane. Okay, it means if I take cross product of this AB and AC vector, AB and AC vector, then this vector will be perpendicular to both, obviously AB and AC, and eventually it will be perpendicular to the plane in which AB and AC is lying. Okay, so this will be a normal vector for us, and points are more than enough, so we can write the equation of plane. You can also join, I have joined A to B and C. You can also join this B to A and C. Okay, you can also join this C to A and C to B. Okay, the answer is not going to change. You are required to find any one perpendicular or normal vector. Okay, so I've written this to be AB cross AC. This is a normal vector for us, and hence I can write the equation of plane to be r minus any one point from where the plane is passing. Let me write it as A. You can write B and C also in the place of A, okay, if you want. Dot a normal vector. Normal vector is in this case I have taken it as AB cross AC. What is AB? AB is nothing but B minus A. And what is AC? AC is nothing but C minus A. Okay, so B minus A cross C minus A. So this is our normal vector in this case. Okay, and this thing is equal to 0 because the equation of plane which is passing through any point A and is normal to n vector is given by r minus a dot n vector is equal to 0. Okay, so again no need to memorize this thing, we can easily find out what is normal vector. So if you also observe in this case, again there is a scalar triple product of these three vector r minus a, b minus a and c minus a. So this equation can also be written as r minus a, b minus a, c minus a. Okay, a scalar triple product or box product is equal to 0. No need to memorize, I am saying again and again, the only thing you need to remember is always look for a point and always look for a normal vector. Okay, yes. And converting any vector form into Cartesian form is not a big task for us. We can obviously put r is equal to x I cap plus y j cap and plus z k cap, and every other thing will be given to us. Okay, so moving on to the next type, that is equation of plane passing through a point A and is parallel to the vectors B and C. So this is nothing different from this case. Okay, plane containing two lines, there's nothing different from this thing. Let me draw this A point. Let us consider this A point to be in the plane because the plane is passing through this point A and the plane is parallel to these two vectors B vector, and let me draw a C vector here. Okay, you will have to visualize these B and C vectors to be parallel to the plane. Okay, this is a 3D figure. I am drawing it on a 2D screen. Okay, so you assume your table or the screen of your phone or tablet, whatever it is, to be a plane, and take two pen or pencils. Okay, consider them to be the vectors B and C, and make them B and C parallel to the plane. Okay, yes. So again we can write this equation of plane by finding a perpendicular or normal vector to the plane because the point is already given to us. Okay, so what will be the normal vector? Because B and C are parallel to the plane, it means B cross C is going to be what? Our normal vector, because B cross C will be perpendicular to B also, it will be perpendicular to C also. Okay, so B cross C is perpendicular to B as well as C, it means it is perpendicular to our given plane. Okay, so again I can write this equation of plane to be r minus a, because the plane is passing through this A point. So r minus a dot our normal vector, in this case the normal vector is given by B cross C, is equal to 0. Okay, fine. Let us take another case. In this case we are required to find the equation of plane which is passing through a given point and a given line. Let the point be A point whose position vector is A. Okay, so this is a point and a given line. Okay, any line which is not passing through this point. Okay, so a different line, let me say r equal to a1 plus lambda times b. Okay, so this line r equal to a1 plus lambda times b, it means this a1 point is on the line, and if the line is in the plane, it means a1 is in the plane also. And our vector b, which is parallel to our line, and because the line is in the plane, it means b is parallel to the plane also. Okay, so again try to look for a point and a normal vector. Okay, so point is now more than enough point, you know, we are required only one point, but here a point is also in the plane, a1 point is also in the plane, so we can write the equation of plane. Equation of plane is r minus a dot normal vector, or I can write r minus a1, because a1 is also in the plane. Okay, so only thing is to look for the normal vector. How do we get the normal vector? This b vector is parallel to the plane. Okay, and these two points lying in the plane, what are the two points? A1 and a. So if we join these two points, we will get a vector according to the direction a minus a1. Okay, so this a minus a1 vector is also parallel to the plane, b vector is also parallel to the plane. So if we take the cross product of these two vectors, which two vector? A minus a1 and this b, because a minus a1, this whole vector is parallel to the plane, b is also parallel to the plane. So if we multiply this vectorly, it means we are going to get a vector which is perpendicular to both the vectors, which is a minus a1 as well as b, and eventually it will be perpendicular to the plane also. Okay, so in this case again our normal vector is going to be, or normal vector is going to be this normal vector. I can take it as b cross a minus a1. Okay, you can also take a minus a1 cross b. Okay, there will be no difference. You can also take lambda times a minus a1 cross b, because eventually we are going to do what? We are going to multiply this with r minus a. Okay, and equating this thing to be 0. So there is no difference if you write lambda, or if you write b earlier, a minus a1 after that. Okay, then going to be no such big difference. Okay, so I can write r minus a dot a minus a1 cross b. So this is our normal vector. Okay, or I can say r minus a1, there is no need to write this thing. Okay, so this is our equation of plane, which is passing through the given point and a given line. Okay, so in each and every case you are saying that there is only one thing which we are doing, is that we are looking for a normal vector, because in most of the cases the point will be already given for us. Okay, the point will be already given, so the only thing we have to look for is normal vector. Okay, so first thing is any point on the plane. Second thing is any normal vector to the plane. Normal means perpendicular. Okay, so information of these two is sufficient for us. There is no need to memorize all these different cases. The only thing you need to memorize is if a plane is passing through A and is normal to n vector, it means the equation of the plane is r minus a dot n vector is equal to 0. Okay, so there are some more forms of a plane. The intercept form of plane. Okay, You may have heard about intercept form of line in 2D geometry in our 11th class. We have seen this type of equation x by a plus y by b is equal to 1. It means it is a line which x intercept is equal to a, which y intercept is equal to b. Okay, so this thing is also true for 3D. Okay, so let this be a plane which is cutting x axis at say point A, y axis at point B, z axis at point C. let us say this point A to be A comma 0 comma 0, this B to be 0 comma B comma 0, and C point to be 0 0 C. Okay, it means x intercept, this portion is called the x intercept, which is equal to A, this y intercept is equal to B, and this z intercept is equal to what? Is equal to C. So we can write the equation of plane whose x intercept is equal to A, whose y intercept is equal to B, and whose z intercept is equal to C as x by A plus y by B plus z by C is equal to 1. Okay, okay, so very easy. We can convert any plane to be in intercept form. Let us say we are given a plane 2x minus 4y plus 6z is equal to 10, or let me take it as 12. Okay, so in order to convert this plane to be in intercept form, this right hand side should be 1, so we can divide it by 12 to get x upon 6 and plus y upon minus 3 plus z upon 2 is equal to 1. So our x intercept is 6, y intercept is minus 3, and z intercept is what? 2. So we can also say that this point of intersection of this plane with x axis is equal to 6 comma 0 comma 0, point of intersection of this plane with y axis is 0 minus 3 comma 0, and point of intersection of this plane with z axis is equal to 0 comma 0 comma 2. Okay, so you can convert any plane into its intercept form. Even if the plane is given in its vector form, let's say the plane is in the form of r dot say I cap minus 2j cap plus 3k cap is equal to 6. Okay, so we know that this r vector is nothing but xi plus yj plus zk. So if we are going to take the dot product, we will get x minus 2i plus 3z is equal to 6, and by dividing with 6 we will get x upon 6 plus y upon minus 3 plus z upon 2 is equal to 1. So x intercept will be 6, y intercept will be minus 3, and z intercept will be 2. Okay, so we can convert any plane, whether in its vector form or Cartesian form, okay, to in intercept form. The other form is this normal form of the plane. What is normal form of the plane? Normal form is that form of the plane in which we are given directly the perpendicular distance of that plane from origin. Okay, if I make you remember this normal form of straight line, okay, let us consider this line, which the normal of this line from origin, let us consider this to be ON. If it's making angle alpha with positive x axis, okay, and having this length as, let's say, length d, okay, so we can easily calculate what is this distance and what is this distance, okay, or let me consider this distance to be p, okay. So if you calculate this x and y intercept and write the equation of line, you will get x cos alpha plus y sin alpha is equal to p. Okay, so this is the line, normal form of the line which we have studied in 11th class in the chapter of straight line. Okay, so this thing again we are going to do in the plane also. Okay, so let us consider this plane. I have taken this plane as x plus y plus z minus 5 is equal to 0. So this is the equation of the plane. Okay, this red axis is x axis for you. Okay, this is x axis, this green one is y axis, and this is z axis, and this is origin. Okay, so this perpendicular distance of the plane from origin, let us consider this distance to be d. Okay, so what will be the equation of this plane in normal form? Okay, so equation is given as x plus y plus z minus 5 is equal to 0. If I convert this plane to vector form, I'll write x plus y plus z is equal to 5 and r dot I cap plus j cap plus k cap is equal to 5, r dot some vector is equal to 5. Okay, obviously this vector is a normal vector for us. Whatever is the coefficient of this x, y and z are the components of normal vector, we have already seen that. So in order to convert this plane to be in normal form, what you have to do is you have to make this normal vector as unit vector. If this normal vector is n vector, you will have to convert this n vector into n cap, okay, in its unit vector. Okay, so for converting this normal vector into its unit vector, we'll have to divide it by its magnitude, that is root 3. Okay, so we'll have to divide this root 3 on the both side, root 3. Okay, so now this vector has converted in this form, r dot n cap is equal to d. Okay, because we have converted this normal vector into its unit vector, and in this case this d is going to give us the perpendicular distance from origin. Okay, so in order to convert any plane into its normal form, you will have to just make this normal vector as its unit vector. Okay, obviously this d is not less than 0, this will be always greater than 0. Okay, if the plane is passing through origin, it means the perpendicular distance from the origin to the plane is 0, it means d can also be 0. So I can write this d as greater than or equal to 0. Okay, so this form is called as the normal form of the plane. Okay, in general form, general form was like this, r minus a dot n vector is equal to 0. Okay, I can write this as r dot n is equal to a dot n. Okay, r dot n is equal to this a dot n is a scalar, so I can write this as, let's say, d. Okay, so this is our general form of plane, r dot n vector is equal to some constant d. Okay, if we convert this normal vector into its unit vector, in that case this constant is going to give us the perpendicular distance from origin, but only when this n vector is in its unit vector. Okay, so let us see some examples based on that. We have to convert these given planes into its normal form, and obviously after converting these planes into normal form, we can determine what is its distance from the origin. Okay, So let us take this first plane, that is r dot 2i cap minus 2j cap plus k cap is equal to 9. Okay, so this is already written in its general form, r dot n vector is equal to some constant, that is 9. If we convert this normal vector into its unit vector, then the constant that will appear in right hand side will give us the perpendicular distance from origin. So in order to convert this 2i minus 2j plus k cap into its unit vector, we will have to divide it by its magnitude. Its magnitude is 3, so we cannot divide 3 in on one side only, we will have to divide by 3 on both sides, and we will get r dot 2i minus 2j plus k cap divided by 3 is equal to what? 3. So this converted into this form, r dot n cap is equal to d. So the perpendicular distance from the origin is equal to 3. Okay, this is the perpendicular distance. Let us take this second plane, which is 3x plus 4y plus 5z plus root 200, okay, is equal to 0. We are required to convert this plane into normal form and hence find the perpendicular distance from the origin. Okay, so let me first write this plane to be in vector form. So this will be the coefficient of this x, y and z. X, y and z coefficient are the components of normal vector. So r dot 3i cap plus 4j cap plus 5k cap is equal to minus root 200. So I can also write this 200 as 10 root 2. Okay. So this we have written in the vector form, like r dot n vector equal to some constant. But this vector, normal vector, is not the unit vector. Okay, so if we convert this to be in unit vector, we'll have to divide this vector by its magnitude. What is its magnitude? Root of 9 plus 16 plus 25, that is root of 50, that is 5 root 2. So we'll have to divide both side by 5 root 2. So what do we get? R dot 3i plus 4j plus 5k divided by 5 root 2 is equal to minus 2. Okay, so 10 root 2 upon 5 root 2 is 2, and minus sign is already there. So obviously we have converted this normal vector into its unit vector, but the fact that this constant is not positive, we cannot say that this form is normal form, because for this to be in normal form, this must represent the perpendicular distance from origin. It cannot be minus 2, so we will have to remove the minus sign from here, and for that we can multiply both side by minus 1. Okay, so by multiplying both side by minus 1, now this vector is a unit normal vector and this is a positive constant. So this we have converted like this, r dot n cap is equal to d. So this is our normal form. And what is its perpendicular distance from origin? Perpendicular distance from origin is equal to 2 units. Okay, so I hope you have understood what is normal form, what is intercept form, and how to write the equation of any plane. Okay, so the next topic is, how do we calculate perpendicular distance of any point from a plane? In the previous topic, we have seen how to determine the perpendicular distance of any plane from origin. But if we are asked the perpendicular distance from let's say any point other than origin, let me consider x1 y1 z1. okay, this is a point x1 y1 z1. It is a given point, and let's say this plane is ax plus by plus cz plus d is equal to 0. So this is our general plane in the Cartesian form. Okay, the plane is also given, the point is also given. We are required to find this perpendicular distance. Okay, so this perpendicular distance d will be, simply we will have to put this point into the plane, into the equation of plane. Okay, so what do we get? A x1 plus b y1 plus c z1 plus d, take this absolute value or divide it by square root of a square plus b square plus c square, which are the coefficients of x, y and z. So this becomes the formula for calculating the perpendicular distance of any point from the plane. Okay, I'm not proving this formula, this is, the proof is not very much required here. Okay, you can prove by yourself also, but let me recall you, what is the perpendicular distance of any point, say x1, y1, from a line which is ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. This thing we have discussed in our 11th class in the chapter straight line. Okay, kya karte the hum log? We simply put this point in the equation of line ax1 plus by1 plus c, we take the absolute value and we divide it by square root of a square plus b square, and we get the perpendicular distance. Okay, so if you can draw some analogy from here, okay, so it will be beneficial for you. You will not have to remember this formula as a separate formula. If you remember how to calculate the perpendicular distance of a point from a line in your 11th class, it means you will also will be knowing this formula also. Okay, let us take an example. Calculate perpendicular distance, or find perpendicular distance of P point say 1, 2, 0 from a plane, let's say x minus y plus z plus 10 equal to 0. Okay, so this perpendicular distance will be just putting this 1, 2 and 0 in the place of x, y and z. So 1 minus 2 plus 0 plus 10, absolute value, and divide it by the coefficient of x, y and z, the square of sum of coefficient. Okay, that is 1 square plus minus 1 square plus again 1 square, and we will get 10 plus 1, 11 minus 2 is 9, 9 upon root 3. So this is our answer. Okay, very simple. Next topic is, how can we find what is the foot of perpendicular and what is the coordinate of image of any point, let's say the point to be x1, y1, z1. Okay, if we drop some perpendicular on a given plane, that the given plane is ax plus by plus cz equal to d. Okay, so how we can calculate this foot of perpendicular? Let this foot of perpendicular to be the point hkl. Okay, so we can apply this formula, h minus x1 upon a, k minus y1 upon b equal to l minus z1 upon c is equal to minus times, we put this x1, y1, z1 in the equation of plane, a x1 plus b y1 plus c z1 plus d, and divide it by a square plus b square plus c square. Okay, so by using this formula, what are these a, b and c? These are simply the coefficients of x, y, z in the given plane. Okay, and what are these x1, y1, z1? X1, y1, z1 are the points, the coordinates of a point from where the foot of perpendicular is drawn. Okay, so you can also remember this formula from your 11th class again. Foot of perpendicular, the only difference was there was this no Z1 part, okay. So this was the only difference. If I consider this A dash point as its image, okay. So let me consider this A dash again as HKL, which is image. So by using this formula H minus X1 upon A equal to K minus Y1 upon B equal to L minus Z1 upon C is equal to minus 2 times, again by putting this X1, Y1, Z1 into the equation of plane, AX1 plus BY1 plus CZ1 plus D whole divided by A square plus B square plus C square. By using this formula, we can get the coordinates of image. Whatever the value of H, K and L will give us image. If we have taken this 2 here, whatever the value of H, K and L without taking 2 will be our foot of perpendicular, okay. So that's all. We will solve some questions. Equation of plane, we will have to write the equation of plane under some different given condition. The first one is the plane is passing through minus 1, 3, 2 and is perpendicular to the plane, sorry, to the vector this, okay. So this is very simplest form. Let this be a vector plane on which minus 1, 3, comma 2 is a point, and our normal vector is what? I minus 2j minus k cap. So the answer is r minus this is our point from where the plane is passing. So r minus position vector of this point, that will be minus I plus 3j plus 2k r minus this dot normal vector, which is given I minus 2j minus k cap is equal to 0. This is our answer. If question says convert this to be in Cartesian form, you can easily convert this by putting this r vector as x I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap, okay. Okay, so what is the second part? You have to find a plane, equation of a plane which is bisecting a line segment, which is bisecting a line segment which is formed by joining the point this 1 comma 2 comma 4 and the other is minus 1 0 comma 2, okay. Our plane is like this, plane is bisecting this line segment, let's say at M point, which M is the midpoint of these 2 point, let me consider this point to be A and B, okay. So in order to find the equation of the plane, we will look for the point from which the plane is passing and its normal vector, okay. So if the plane is bisecting, and I will have to write plane is bisecting the line segment joining this and also perpendicular to the line, okay. So if plane is perpendicular, it means this BA vector is itself our normal vector. So this will be 1 minus minus 1 2 I cap, 2 minus 0 2 j cap plus 4 minus 2 in 2 k cap. So this is our normal vector, and the midpoint of these two points A and B is the point from where the plane is passing. We can consider this point, we can easily calculate this point by using midpoint formula. So we'll get 0 1 3, okay. So we get a point, we have a normal vector, so we can easily write the equation of plane r minus this the position vector of a point from where the line is, sorry, the plane is passing, and this is j cap plus 3 k cap dot this normal normal vector, that is I cap plus j cap plus k cap is equal to 0. If the normal vector is 2 I cap plus 2 j cap plus 2 k cap, we can also write I cap plus j cap plus k cap, okay. If you write 2 here, there will be no change, okay. It's your choice, you can write 2 you cannot. Okay, so moving on to the third part, we have to write the equation of a plane which is perpendicular, which is obviously passing through the origin and perpendicular to this line. Okay, so our plane is passing through origin, it means 0 0 0, and is perpendicular to a line. What is the line? Line is given as this. Okay, so this parallel vector of line, if line is perpendicular to the plane, it means the parallel vector, this B vector, which is 2i minus j plus 2k, okay, this is our normal vector also, because line is perpendicular to the plane. It means the vector which is parallel to the line is also perpendicular to the plane. So we have a normal vector, we have a point, we can write r minus 0 dot this vector 2i minus j plus 2k cap is equal to 0. This is our answer. We can obviously convert this vector form of plane into our Cartesian form if we want. Okay, this is another question. We are required to find the equation of a plane which is passing through these three points A, B and C. Let this point A, B and C. Okay, so in order to find a normal vector, we join this A to B and A to C. So our AB cross AC is normal vector. Okay, so we can easily find out what is AB cross AC. For that you will have to write AB vector and AC vector. Okay, so that is our normal vector, and point we can take any of these three points A, B and C. Okay, then we can write R minus A dot whatever the normal vector we get from here is equal to 0. Okay, fifth part says we have to write the equation of the plane which is xy plane. Okay, xy plane, what is xy plane? This is our x axis, y axis, z axis, origin. So this is our xy plane. Okay, so in order to write the equation of xy plane, we must have a normal vector, which is in this case k cap. Okay, you can easily see in this k cap, which is in the direction of z axis, is normal to our xy plane. Okay, and xy plane is passing through origin, so I can write r minus 0 dot k cap is equal to 0. Okay, so r minus 0 is nothing but r, and r is what? Xi plus yj plus z k cap dot k cap is equal to 0 will give us z is equal to 0. So z equal to 0 is the equation of xy plane. Similarly, you can find out what is the equation of yz plane. This will be x is equal to 0, and what is the equation of zx plane? This will be y is equal to 0. Okay, the next part is you have to find the equation of plane which is containing these two lines. Okay, plane is containing these two lines. So let this is our plane. See, the this given lines are not parallel. Okay, but these lying on the same plane, it means the lines are intersecting. Okay, so how do we get our normal vector? This vector, let me call it as b1, and this parallel vector of line 2, let me call it as b2. Okay, so b1 and b2 are parallel to line, and line is itself in the plane. So b1 and b2 are the parallel vector to the plane also. So if we take cross product of b1 and b2, so this will be normal to the plane. Okay, so in this manner we can find out what is the normal vector. And how can we get any point on the plane? If this line, first line, completely lie inside the plane, because the question says the plane containing the line. Okay, means if the line is in the plane, every point on the line is also in the plane. So from first line we can see that 5 comma 7 comma minus 3 is a point on the line. It means 5 7 minus 3 is also on the plane. Okay, so again we can write r minus a dot, our normal vector is equal to 0. Okay, next part is we have to write the equation of a plane which is passing through a point. Again, the point is given, but the plane is perpendicular to each of the plane, this and this. Okay, this you have to understand very well. This is a plane. Okay. First, observe that normal vector of this first plane, that is n1 vector, is I cap plus 2j cap plus 3k cap. Normal vector of this second plane is 3i cap plus 3j cap plus k cap. How we have written is this normal vector directly, because the coefficient of x, y and z, these tell us what are the component of our normal vector. Okay. Okay, so observe this, that this normal vector n1 and n2 vector are not collinear. Okay, this I cap plus 2j cap plus 3k cap is nowhere collinear or parallel to this second normal vector, that is 3i cap plus 3j cap plus k cap. It means these two planes, this let me call this plane to be p1 and this second plane to be p2, p1 and p2 are not parallel. Normal vectors are not parallel, it means planes are also not parallel. Okay, it means these planes are what? Intersecting planes. So we have to write an equation of a plane which is perpendicular to these planes p1 and p2 both. Okay, so let us consider n is required normal vector of plane. Okay, so required plane p is perpendicular to p1. It means our normal vector n is perpendicular to n1. The required plane p is also perpendicular to the given plane p2. It means our required normal vector is also perpendicular to the second normal vector, that is n2. Now observe, our required normal vector is perpendicular to both n1 and n2. It means n1 is in the direction of n1 cross n2. So again, by taking this cross product n1 and n2, we can get our normal direction, and the point is already given. This is the point. Okay, so again we can write the equation of plane. Okay, there are only two things that we always want to know, that is point and a normal vector. Okay, this is our last question. We have to find the equation of a plane which is passing through the straight line this means the plane is containing this straight line. Okay, plane is containing this straight line, and our plane is perpendicular to this given plane. Okay, so let this given plane is p1, so the normal vector to plane p1 will be I cap minus j cap plus k cap. Okay, plane is perpendicular, our required plane. Let me draw clear diagram. This is our given plane p1. Okay, and we are looking for a plane like this. This is our required plane, which is perpendicular to the given plane. It means the normal vector of given plane p1 and the normal vector of our required plane, these both are what? Again perpendicular. It means if again I assume n vector n to be our required n vector to be normal vector of required plane, it means n is perpendicular to n1. Also this required plane is containing a line. Okay, this required plane is containing a line, and line is parallel to a vector, which is this vector. Let me call it as B vector, which is 2i minus 3j plus 5k. Okay, so this 2i minus 3j plus 5k is parallel to the line which is in the plane. It means this vector is again parallel to our required plane, and finally this becomes perpendicular to our normal vector. It means our normal vector is also perpendicular to this 2i minus 3j plus 5k cap. So again you can clearly see n is perpendicular to n1 also, n is perpendicular to this vector also. It means n is in the direction of n1 cross whatever this vector is, 2i minus 3j plus 5k. Okay, n1, you already know what is n1, so by taking this cross product we can have our normal vector. And how do we get the point? Because this line which is completely inside the plane, it means this point 1, -2, 0, 1, -2, 0, point which is on the line is also on the plane. Okay, so our point from where the line is passing is also the point from where the plane is passing, and that is 1, -2, 0. Okay, so again we can write r minus a dot normal vector is equal to 0 as our equation of plane. Okay.